It's Mike, and welcome back to another day of Discovering Density with Monshire at Home. Yesterday, we layered salt and fresh water, taking advantage of their differences in density. And today, we're going to layer water again, but this time without salt, and instead, just using waters with different temperatures. When we change the temperature of a substance, it reacts by expanding or contracting. Add heat to something, we give it more energy, and this causes the atoms and molecules to move around more. It gives them more kinetic energy, and they push out and expand. Take away the heat, the atoms and molecules lose some kinetic energy. They move around with less intensity, and the substance contracts. So with my water, it is taking up less and less volume as it gets colder. If the amount of stuff, its mass, stays the same, we're not adding or taking away water, but its volume is getting smaller as it contracts. Then we're changing the density. The density of my water is increasing the colder it gets. If we heat it up, the energy causes the water to expand, take up more space, and the larger volume means its density decreased from what it was at room temperature. Now, can't really see those changes in volume in the cups here, but we can do an experiment, and I'm going to follow pretty much the same procedure we did with our salt water liquid rainbows yesterday. And I'm going to add the more dense water first, in this case my cold water, and then add the hot water on top of it. And we can see those layers inside. If I tried it the other way, with the hot water first, and then put my cold water on top, we can see that colder water just sinking right down through. And perhaps you might have experienced this in nature before. If you've ever been out in a pond or a lake and your feet dangle down and you feel this real cold layer of water, that's something called thermal stratification. And it happens when the sun heats up the top layer of water and the bottom remains cold. And maybe you're also thinking, but wait, if water is getting more and more dense, the colder it gets, and it keeps getting colder and colder, eventually it's going to turn into a solid, into ice. But ice floats. It's not more dense than water, but that's because water is pretty special. As it nears its freezing point, it expands, and so ice floats. Most every other chemical, if you take its solid version and put it into its liquid version, it's going to sink. But water is pretty unique. And for the experiment I want you to try today is you're going to take then some regular room temperature fresh water and also a glass of room temperature salt water. To make the salt water, you're just going to take a spoonful of salt and stir it in and let it dissolve. Get another spoonful and stir it in and keep doing that until no more salt will dissolve into your water. At that point, it's going to be saturated and you'll be ready to begin your experiment. Into each glass, we're going to put an ice cube, but not just a regular ice cube. We're going to put in some colored ice cubes that'll help us see what's going on in there a little bit easily. Now, I'm not going to do this right now. I'll do it later and put it up, my video up, but I want you to be able to do it and experience it for yourself. But before you put the ice cubes in, maybe ask a couple questions. Is the ice going to behave the same in both? Is it going to melt at the same rate in our fresh water and our salt water? when it's all done, are these glasses going to look the same after our ice cubes are completely melted? This is a really cool experiment, and I want you to be able to experience it for yourself. So happy experimenting, and we'll check in again real soon with some more density experiments.